Lord, whatever you're doing in this season, don't do it without me. Don't do it without me. I said, Lord, whatever you're doing in this season, don't do it without me. Don't do it without me. Hey, hope all is well. Praying that everybody is safe and in good health. Amen. Well, today's topic is God is training you to hear his voice. God is training you to hear his voice. Yes, he is. But you know, before we get into this word, we have to pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you for your grace, mercy, and favor. Lord God, we thank you for speaking to us and having faith that we will obey what you're telling us to do. In the name of Jesus, may I decrease and you increase in me, Lord God. Speak forth this word like only you can do. And may each and every person that comes across this video be supernaturally blessed. Meet the needs of each and every household, and I decree and declare that's done in the mighty name of Jesus. God is training you to hear his voice. Well, yesterday, you all, while I was out looking for some red to wear to church today, I didn't know what I wanted. I didn't know if I wanted a dress or a pantsuit. But when I get in the store, you all, they had this pretty dress that I really wanted bad, okay? But they did not have my size. So I was kind of like sad or whatever. But I got the pantsuit. It's still clean. But but anyways, I paid for my things and I left the store, okay? Not even a half mile down the road, God said, turn around and go back. And I didn't see the need for me to turn around and go back, so I kept driving. God said it again. He said, turn around and go back to the store. So I started to think, God want me to have that dress. It's something. If God telling me to do this, it's something in there. I must have overlooked that dress, that size of that dress. So let me turn around and go back and look thoroughly, okay? So I went back to the store, y'all, and went through the dresses, looked again, and they didn't have my size. And so I was like, okay, God, what was the use of me turning around and coming back to this store? It was pointless. It was useless. He said, it was not useless. I wanted to see what you listen to me, whether you understood the assignment or not. I wanted to see, could you hear my voice? I'm training you to hear my voice. And so God is training you all to hear his voice. So we have to be attentive to the voice of God in this season. Amen. And he led me to John 8:47. And it says, whoever is of God hears the word of God. The reason why you do not hear them is that you are not of God. So you all, we have to listen to God. We do not want to be counted as not being of God or not being his. We are children of God, so we must listen to the voice of God. Amen. And then I have Romans 10:17, and it says, so faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. Yes, the Lord speaks to us through his word. So we have to read the Bible. Amen. But in this season, God is training you to personally hear his voice outside of the Bible. So we got to read the Bible so that it can enable us to be able to hear him through our ears. Amen. We have to listen to the voice of God. We must obey God's voice at all costs. At all costs. Amen. And it says right here that Samuel is a perfect example why we should be attentive to God's voice. Samuel. Okay. I will give you a little backstory about Samuel, who served in the temple of Eli. He served when Eli was in the temple. And you can go read 1 Samuel for yourself. But I'm going to just give a little briefing of the text. And it was saying that when Samuel was a young child, his mother promised God that Samuel would serve him in his childhood. But Samuel ended up moving with Eli into the temple because Eli had some sons that wasn't interested in God, wasn't interested in the Jewish laws and rituals. And really, they did everything that was contrary to the word of God. Amen. But Eli was so old that he was soon to die, and his sons were supposed to serve after him, but they weren't interested, so God couldn't use them. Amen. So you have to be interested in what God is telling you, because you got to have a pure heart and listen to the voice of God. But anyway, Samuel had a pure heart, and so God paid him attention. Samuel actually heard God's voice three times before Eli even realized that it was God that was speaking to Samuel. Okay, so about the third time that God had spoke to Samuel, Eli told him, he said, the next time you hear that voice, say, Lord, here I am. Speak, Lord, here I am. So with Eli's sons not having any interest in, you know, taking over serving God after him, God can use them. So God ended up using Samuel. And it was very, very important that Samuel listened to the voice of God, because he needed to get Eli that message that what was about to happen to them. And it was so bad that Samuel didn't even want to deliver the message, but Eli wanted to know. So he asked Samuel, what was it that God had said? Amen. So we have to be attentive, because that information that God is giving you is very detrimental to your new lifestyle. Amen. So you got to listen. And God just might be using you to tell somebody something that you don't want to tell them. It don't matter. You still got to do it, just like Samuel. Samuel didn't want to tell Eli, but he had to tell him anyway. So God is searching and looking for those who he can trust with his word, who can trust that they will obey his voice. Amen. You got to have a pure heart and obedience to God when he is speaking. Amen. Okay, let me see what else I have here. Okay, so it says that back in Samuel and them time, God used priests and prophets to speak to the people. They used a mediator, but this day and time, God uses his Holy Spirit. So God is using the Holy Spirit to speak to you. Amen. And then I got John 14:21. Oh, no, my Bible isn't upside down. Let me turn to John 14. No, I wasn't about to start saying Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. I have John 14:21, and it says, what do it say? It says, he who has my commands and keep them, it is he who loves me, and he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and manifest myself in them. So if I first have God, so I must first have God's word, then obey it. Then I will receive the Holy Spirit as I am faithful. I learn to hear the voice in my heart more and more, and it can guide me in my daily life. Let me read that again. It says, so if I first have God's word and then obey it, then I will receive the Holy Spirit as I am faithful. I learn to hear that voice in my heart more and more, and it can guide me in my daily life. So we must obey God's word, obey God's voice, be faithful to hear God's voice so that he can guide us in our daily lives. You all, God spoke to Samuel about an important task, and it was delivering a message to see will he be faithful. Will you be faithful to what God is telling you to do? So in this time, just know that you're being tested to see if you're being faithful. So be attentive to the voice of God. According to 1 Samuel 3:15, it says Samuel was afraid to tell Eli what God had said, but Eli wanted to hear it. So Samuel told him, and God had promised Eli and his sons, and established Samuel as a prophet. By that time, Eli knew that Samuel was a prophet. And just as well, when God send you somewhere and tell you to do something, he will make known to other people that you are who you say you are, and that God has sent you. God is sending you somewhere, and the people will know that it was God who sent you. Amen. Well, that was all I have, that God is training you to hear his voice. And that anytime that God speaks, you need to move when God say move, whether you understand the instructions or not. And you don't want to be confused whether it's your voice, God's voice, or Satan's voice. If you go through this training and be attentive and listen and obey right now, you won't have that confusion going on. You won't be confused about whether it's God or not that's speaking to you. So you all, that is very, very, very important that you learn God's voice. Have a pure heart and learn it, because I'm going to just give you a quick testimony of what happened to me a couple years ago. And the devil hear your prayers, y'all. It's kind of a long story, so I'm going to try to get every detail in there. without being long-winded. But anyways, back in 2014, I had written down some things that I wanted God to do. And at this time, y'all, I was one fasting sister and praying sister and in my word. So I just wanted to live right. So I was just writing down some things that I wanted to correct in my life and that I wanted in my life so that I wouldn't be falling short in sin like that. You know what I'm saying? So I written down what everything I wanted in a husband, okay? And I told God, you know, I wanted a husband, and I told God what I wanted in a husband, okay? And so I didn't pay no attention, but that same night I written down my note to God and I put it in my Bible, y'all. I had a dream. I seen this guy's face, and I told God, you know, show me my husband's face so I can know him when I see him. And so I seen the face, so I woke up excited. But I do know that God uses me to pray for people, you know. So I start to pray for him, and I was like, nah, God wasn't saying that was my husband. But in the dream, it was. That's what he was telling me. So it was kind of confusion from that point on anyways. But I should have paid attention to it, but I didn't. I was just excited that God said I was going to have a husband. Little do that I know, that wasn't the voice of God. But anyways, let me finish the story of how I was blindsided or I was confused. But anyways, I'm going to say after I wrote that letter and put it in there, probably like 8 months later, I seen this guy at my church. So I asked my sister, I was like, who is that? And I was like, that's the guy that God showed me, you know, that was going to be my husband the day I written it down and put it in there. And so I never did tell my sister what God had told me. I just asked her who that was. She told me it was, and I was like, man, God, no, that's that, no, because she told me his age and who he was and who child it was and all that. And I was like, God, no. And I kind of stomped out of church kind of mad or whatever. But anyways, after that, I was like, years passed by. So I done said, okay, God, I ain't married yet. You got to, I'll pray again another time. So I was laying in my bed, and I took a picture of my feet, y'all. And so I posted the picture on Facebook of my feet. But I told God out loud, I said, God, let only my husband tell me I have pretty feet. And so I posted it on Facebook. I didn't put the words on there, but I just posted the picture to see what everybody was going to say. Because I don't think I have the prettiest feet in the world, but they not ugly. They okay. You know what I'm saying? So I just told God, let only my husband tell me I have pretty feet, y'all. Y'all, it's years later, 2020, after 2016, 17, maybe 2020. I see the same guy that God showed me in my dream that was supposed to be my husband. I see that same guy, and he said, and you got some pretty feet too. I didn't think about it when he said it, but the next day I was at work, God had showed me that picture I posted on Facebook, and he said that. Didn't he say that yesterday? And I was like, sure did. You know, I spent around in my work chair. I was like, sure did. But I was like, God, that boy don't be paying me no attention. He ain't studying me. Y'all, I'm going to tell you what happened to me. I ended up in a one-night stand because I approached him. And I said something to him because I was sick and tired of that. You know, he ain't paying me no attention. He bringing all these women up in the church. I was sick of it. So I said something to him, y'all. I ended up in a one-night stand, and that was not none of God who told me that was my husband. I was confused. I let the enemy play with my mind, and so I was just like, you know, ain't no way that this is my husband. Like, and after the one-night stand, you all, I called him, like, a year or so later, because I was thinking that it still was, and I was thinking like maybe something just happened. He's scared, or he probably just don't like me, but I know he don't like me. He got an issue with me having kids. He got an issue with my eyes being like they is. Some things that I just know that I can't explain to y'all, that I just know. And so I know that wasn't God speaking to me. That was the devil. The devil hear your prayers too. He hear your prayers too. And so y'all, that, and it still strike up something in me to this day, and that I have to, deal with, that I pray against, because it was so many years in between that played in my mind and in my heart for so long. And it ain't the person that, it's just that I knew I had a husband, and I thought that was him, but I ain't worried about the person part of it. It's just, I just knew I had a husband. And y'all, the devil heard my prayer, and he played on it for years and years and years. Because the devil know your weakness. He know what you want. So you got to really, really, really be attentive to the voice of God and make sure it was God, because confusion is not of God. You know what I'm saying? So I still sometimes think about it to this day, but I pray against it every time. I shun it off and I pray against it. As soon as that thought try to come up in my head, I pray against it. Lord, annihilate that memory. And so, yeah, I had to give you all that testimony because, y'all, I ended up in a one-night stand, and that's the worst encounter I have had with a man a day in my life. And so that's terrible. That's real terrible. But, yeah, it's not his fault. It's not my fault. Well, it's my fault because I should have been praying and fasting and really listening to the voice of God. But ain't no way that God said that, because one thing about it, when I made that phone call, that last phone call, and he answered the phone for me, he talked loud, he talked over me, and he be cursing and stuff like that, you know, and I'm just like, God ain't gonna tell my husband to talk to me like that. Ain't no way. So I start coming up out of that trance I was in, that obsession. It was an obsession, and I was just like, dang, okay. Even his dad had posted it one time. We was on online church service, and I seen his dad post it. He was like, it's an obsession. So I listened to my father in Christ. I said, okay, since it's an obsession, I start praying against obsession. I start thinking like, no, that ain't no way God will tell me that. Ain't no possible way. And so I start praying against it. And now I'm going to go on another fast because it still comes up sometimes. But y'all, I do not want y'all to end up in a situation like that or in a worse situation like that. So do not be confused about who's speaking to you. Amen. So we got to be trained by God to hear his voice, because that was the worst experience with a man I have ever had. And I never want that to happen again. So I'm going to listen to the voice of God and obey. It ain't going to be no ifs, ands, or buts about who's speaking to me, whether it's something that I desire myself. Is it God's voice or is it Satan's voice? And that was something I was desiring myself. Sometimes we can want something so bad, such as a marriage, and don't want to be sinning. We get tired of waiting. Y'all, you're just going to have to keep waiting on God, because our own emotions and our own feelings can lead us into some destruction just because it's something we want. Okay, so listen for the voice of God. I pray that this added to you. God bless, and may you all, Lord, keep him first in everything you do. Be attentive to the voice of God, because God is training us to hear his voice. Amen. God bless.